Guy Verhofstadt sat on the board of Belgian shipping firm Exmar, which was named in the Paradise Papers Paul FaithAFP via Getty Images. Guy Verhofstadt, the Liberal group leader in the European Parliament, came under fire Tuesday over his links to a firm mentioned in the Paradise Papers. Verhofstadt sat on the board of Exmar, a Belgian shipping firm, which used an offshore company mentioned in the recent Paradise Papers leaked documents about circumventing tax rules through offshore investments. The revelations about Verhofstadt were made public by Belgium's far-left Workers' Party on Tuesday evening. The former Belgian prime minister sat on Exmar Group's board of directors between 2010 and 2016. Its annual reports show he received €60,000 per year. The company's board of directors also includes Howard Gutman, former U.S. President Barack Obama's ambassador to Belgium. The Paradise Papers mention Exmar Offshore in Bermuda, part of the Exmar Group. Set up in 1997, Exmar Offshore provides energy services. Nicholas Averies, chief executive officer of Exmar Group, described Exmar Offshore, a group of separate but related companies, as an engineering company headquartered in Houston, Texas. According to Savories, the Bermuda-based company is extremely limited in scope, adding that it is a dormant company which carries out minimal activities. Exmar Offshore has a limited company in Bermuda, its main company in the U.S., a services division in Luxembourg and a limited company in Belgium, its most recent annual report shows. Savories said it is the duty of a company executive or manager to find the least taxable route and described recent revelations about offshore taxation optimization as a witch hunt. Peter Mertens, president of the Workers' Party, said Verhofstadt can't claim he wasn't aware of the existence of this Bermuda-based company. The activities of Exmar Offshore Limited were in the consolidated accounts and he received €60,000 as director to know this. Verhofstadt's spokesperson Bram Dellen said this is fake news in the purest sense of the word. Exmar Offshore engages in activities that are literally off the coast, such as platforms in the sea, which has nothing at all to do with offshore in the fiscal sense of the word. The PVDA Workers' Party deliberately creates confusion on the basis of misleading definitions. On top of that, Verhofstadt has left the board of the company more than a year ago. This article was updated with reaction from Verhofstadt. View comments posted on 1-12117-843-PM set at G-European values. Cheating, lying and stealing. Posted on 1-12117-852-PM set resign posted on 1-12117-856-PM set don't listen to them Hofsti, I still love you, moi ex posted on 1-12117-935-PM set it Alan glad you caught my drift. Posted on 1-12117-945-PM set come on people this is Guy Verhofstadt we're talking about here, he's the original Superfly guy. All that's happened here is Russianers working alongside Nigel Farage and Donald Trump and paid for by Vladimir Putin, have ed the computer network and planted fake documents. This is simply fake news by Politico and they playing directly into the Putin's hands. I hope Guy's lawyers will put an end to this matter posted on 1-12117-1032-PM, said if this man has engaged in tax havens, he should be judged for his crimes within EU law. Posted on 1-12117-1047-PM set too much good news. First Merkel and now Verhofstadt, Europe will be a much better place without them. Posted on 1-12217-222-M set Pexit it's only a little part of the reality, Guy is still in the board of the Dutch company. For which he arranged a sale and leaseback contract when he was Belgium PM, and he is also on the payslip of a company linked with Putin, he receives more bribes now from private companies that his salary is European deputy, for how is Guy really working, it's called liberal democracy, be gone you faking troll, no one is buying your fairy tales this isn't Fox News US, please. Posted on 1-12217-228-M set no wonder. He must have serious problems if he cannot see the difference between an offshore company and an offshore oil rig posted on 1-12217-409-M set Philip May is a money launderer Business Insider report dated 16 November. Theresa May's husband's firm named in the Paradise Papers leak ha 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 I can't stop laughing today. Stop it. Honestly, I'm crying. Stop it, please. Ha 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 posted on 1-12217-549-M set too much good news. First my posts were deleted and now my postings, Politico will be a much better place without us. Posted on 1-12217-551-M set at fake wow ha 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 everyone knows Tories support these things. But guys, ALDE asked for an inquiry into himself. Ha ha ha, you are so slow and dim, you do not understand how funny the irony is. Ha ha ha, Paradise Papers MEPs call for permanent committee of inquiry into Parliament Magazine EU. The 7th of November 2017, the Paradise Papers reveal how Apple sidestepped a 2013 crackdown, states would be an important step in the fight against these sorts of crimes. Parliament's ALDE group leader Guy Verhofstadt has warned that the EEU, you guys pro are too funny as you are quite dim and slow. I should anti-laugh at you really, it's mean. Posted on 112217858 MSET. Dear Guy, posted on 112217918 MSET. Wonder if Safina will appear anywhere. Mugabe gone, Adams going, Merkel likely to go, Verhofstadt in the poo, it just gets better. Better posted on 112217931 MSET. Liberals criminals. Posted on 112217945 MSET. European elites. Junka, Verhofstadt crows, how much we do not know about the others. I think these people should disappear from politics once and for all. In fact, they should go to prison for what they did to all of us. Imagine how much public service and social support has deteriorated for the lack of these funds. Posted on 112217102 MSET at BC. Too much good news. First my posts were deleted and now my postings. Politico will be a much better place without us. Is that you guy pretending to be BC and talking nonsense and invectives like you do on a daily basis in the EU Parliament? Posted on 112217104 MSET. This is one of the hypocrites that recently signed a resolution to condemn my country after being mentioned in the Paradise Papers. Posted on 112217-1122, MSET. Guy will soon also have a chance to face in court thousands of average Polish people offended by him, by likening them to Germans of 193,040s who murdered 6 million Polish citizens by calling them Nazis, like for example Dr. Barayondoka, who prepares to file a suit. YouTube.com BCBCV5VTTOOA. We shall see how brave Guy is outside of EU offices, or if he will just chicken out and hide behind his immunity privilege not to face people he so grossly offended. Posted on 112217159 MSET. Dig a bit deeper in Verhofstadt's activities, Politico. You will find Putin marked money. Posted on 112217358 MSET at Ling and begone, you faking troll. No one is buying your fairy tales. This isn't Fox News US, please. Your beloved guy has introduced only in this cadence 9 revisions of his declaration. Could you explain us why a company like APG has appointed him at his board? Or why he is the administrator of so final and receive higher wages from this company only than his wages as MEP, and why he has so much extra remunerations? Is he working for the people as MEP, or is a representative of the companies by which he is paid, or has been paid, or will be soon paid? Posted on 112217423 MSET. Liberal democracy in the purest sense of the word. Posted on 112217432 MSET. Mr. Guy Verhofstadt is one of the most respectable politicians in Europe. Offshore companies are something we don't give a toss. You anti-EU democracy, pro-Kremlin dictatorship trolls, sod fkin off. Cuties. Posted on 1122171102 MSET. Wow, I know it's so funny. Bwahahaha, just like the royal family. Ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha-ha 5 MSET pecs. It does seem suspicious, but we can be sure that this will be looked into thoroughly now when it's in the papers. So, better to await some impartial investigation than letting opportunistic trolls spinning their own continuations of the story, because I don't suppose you have any proof or reliable sources to your quite detailed revelations, delivered with such great conviction if it does turn out to be true, that everyone will want to see action being taken, of course. Posted on 11231-7220, MSET at Lingen the Queen ISNT ironic. Guy asked for investigation into himself. It's called irony. No wonder you're all dull as dishwater. Here's an explanation of iron on honorony from a Canadian, with a Brit, on his American show. That's not ironic, by the way. Posted on 11231-7904, MSET at Lingen does seem suspicious, but we can be sure that this will be looked into thoroughly now when it's in the papers. So, better to await some impartial investigation than letting opportunistic trolls spinning their own continuations of the story, because I don't suppose you have any proof or reliable sources to your quite detailed revelations, delivered with such great conviction. Seems that you're still living in a dreamed perfect world. Impartial investigations? Never saw such thing as impartial investigation in an administration as the Ivy Reich, where all key positions are the result of a political decision. Nelly Kroes was violating all Commissar law obligations, result nothing. Barroso is now getting his bribe in the bank that has created the Euro-Greek issue, and German Chancellor Schroeder is a Putin puppet, as the majority of the German politicians posted on 1-12317-944 IM said. It relates also to Guy's lies. The 20th of November 2017 Consul General Golubievsky's letter to the editor of the New York Times, not admitted for publication. The Consulate General of the Republic of Poland publishes in its entirety a letter to the editor of the New York Times written by the Consul General, Maciej Golubievsky, on the 12th of November 2017 in response to the NYT reporting piece by Megan Specia titled Nationalist March Dominates Poland's Independence Day. According to the New York Times editorial guidelines, letters to the editor, if chosen for publication, are generally published within a week. Unfortunately, the letter was not published, rather two other NYT editorial pieces on the 14th of November by the editorial board, Torches and Hate on the March in Poland, and on the 16th of November by Janti Gross, Poles Cry for Pure Blood Again, that included gross generalizations regarding the Independence March in Warsaw, and criticisms of the Polish government followed suit within a week while the consulate was waiting for the letter's publication. Given its length, the letter was also sent as a potential opt, again to no avail. Dear editor, I am writing to add some context and to clarify certain statements that appeared in the New York Times otherwise balanced report titled Nationalist March Dominates Poland's Independence Day by Megan Specia on the 11th of November 2017. In the past 8 years, a Polish not-for-profit association, Independence March, has organized a popular Poland's Independence Day March in Warsaw. It traditionally draws a large and diverse crowd of around 50,000 participants, mainly non-organized young people and families with children. It owes its success to a non-partisan nature of the march, which is guaranteed by the association's bylaws. The officially declared goal of this annual event is to pay homage to all who contributed to the rebirth of the Polish state after 123 years of captivity, to manifest pride in belonging to the Polish nation, and to promote modern forms of patriotism. Contrary to the statement in the article, the rally has not been growing. In fact, according to police reports, this year's march attracted 60,000 participants, which is 15,000 fewer than last year. Organized groups and associations that take part in the march form a minority of participants, but a fact that the association's board consists of activists of National Movement Party, the march is often labeled by its political competitors on the radical left as AFA2ist march. It is important to note that the National Movement Party and its candidates poll between 0.5-1.5% in national elections. Given such marginal support, the party has withdrawn from political competition, with some of its members seeking electoral fortunes on electoral lists of other parties on the broadly conceived political right. The party sees itself as a socially conservative, Christian nationalist party, which in its official mission statement sees the nation as a cultural community of generations, past, present and future. Its members have consistently and publicly disavowed racially based political doctrines as contrary to the Catholic Christian doctrine, which they see as the moral basis for its political activity. It is telling that even such relatively mild formulation of nationalism garners so little political support in Poland. Given the aforementioned context, it would be difficult to justify a general thesis of the article that the march consisted of thousands of far-right nationalists, although it is understandable that for some far-right may coincide with espousing policies based on socially conservative Catholic social doctrine. If that indeed is so, then it would be accurate to say that the majority of the participants in the march most likely were Sunday churchgoers with conservative social positions on cultural issues of life and family. It is incorrect to state that the theme of this year's march, We Want God, derives from an old Polish nationalist. In fact, the Polish religious belonging to a religious, not a nationalist repertoire of the same title derives from a French original, Nous voulons Dieu, written and composed by a French priest, François-Xavier Moreau, in 1882 to protest for statization policies of the French government at the time. Returning to the issue of apparent displays of racist banners at the march, both the government of Poland and the organizers have unequivocally condemned what seems to have been actions by a fringe minority of protesters. The presence of supporters of the national radical camp mentioned in the article would fit that definition. The official position expressed by the Deputy Prime Minister Peter Glinski very clearly states that the Polish government does not in any way support any expressions of racial or ethnic conceptions of a nation. Additionally, as you may recall, Poland's foreign ministry condemned the proposed participation of a controversial U.S. white supremacist Richard Spencer in the march. The organizers said that such scandalous behavior would not be tolerated and more attention will be paid next year to eliminate such displays and groups. The Warsaw police chief during the press conference after the march also stipulated that the footage of the march will be studied carefully and the suspect cases of spreading racial or fascist speech will be duly investigated. I hope that this rather lengthy explanation of context as well as a clear statement of unequivocally critical attitude of the current government towards displays of racist or ethnic nationalism by fringe groups in Poland will allow you to get a clear picture of political sentiments of patriotic Poles that displayed their Independence Day spirit at yesterday's march in Warsaw. Posted on 1-12317-1056, M said at Wow the Queen, giving name to Her Majesty's Revenue and Customs aka UK's Tax Collection Authority, involved in tax avoidance schemes is not ironic. I guess it's not just quant stuff that you're fantastically bad at. Posted on 1-12317-301, PM said.